Hello, I'm Dr. Amna Jaz from MedicoVisual.com, and today I'm going to present you a review lecture on the female reproductive cycle. It consists of a series of monthly cyclical changes in the female body that makes a pregnancy possible. It consists of two cycles that are going side by side, that is uterine cycle and the ovarian cycle. The average length of the female reproductive cycle is of 28 days. It can be divided into pre-ovulatory, ovulation and post-ovulatory phases. So under the influence of gonadotropin releasing hormone, there is a release of FSH and LH from the interior pituitary, which causes these primordial follicle to grow from unilamellar primary follicle to multilamellar primary follicle with the formation of these theca cell around it. These theca cells secrete testosterone that is converted by this granulosa cell into estrogen, and there is formation of small fluid filled cavities inside it. As the follicles are growing, we can call it follicular phase of the ovarian cycle. This follicle is growing in size and it producing more and more estrogen, so estrogen level will start increasing. And what happens in the uterus? In initial days, there is bleeding from the previous cycle, that is menstruation, and then under the influence of estrogen, it starts proliferating. Then we can call it proliferative phase of the uterine cycle. Then these small fluid filled cavities coalesce to form this antrum, and size of the follicle further increases and it produces more and more estrogen, so estrogen level start rising. Due to the rise in estrogen level, there is a slight decline in the level of FSH, but LH level remains unchanged. As the level of estrogen reaches to its peak, it causes a sudden rise in the level of LH, and we call it LH surge. There is also rise in the FSH, that is FH surge, but that is not that much significant. Then there is ovulation, that at about day 14, and this secondary ovocyte is released, and the remaining follicle is converted into the yellow progesterone producing body, then we call it corpus luteum. As the corpus luteum is produced, we call it luteal phase of the ovarian cycle. The function of this corpus luteum is to produce large amount of the progesterone, so its levels start rising. Progesterone causes three changes in the uterus, that is these blood vessels become engorged and tortuous, and there is formation of glycogen filled cells, and these glands will become deepened and more tortuous. And there is a secretion of the uterine milk to meet the nutritional requirement of coming baby, and we can call it secretory phase of the uterine cycle. Corpus luteum is producing large amount of progesterone and relatively less amount of estrogen, and during all these phases, level of FSH and LH remain at the baseline. But what if pregnancy doesn't occur? This corpus luteum is turned into a white scarred structure called corpus albicans. As corpus luteum has degenerated, the level of progesterone and estrogen will fall, and there will be slight increase in the level of FSH and LH to begin the new cycle. And what happens to this uterus that was ready for the baby? Its wall will shed off and there will be bleeding, and the new cycle will start again. So we can see it in a different angle, that there is, you can see follicular phase of ovarian cycle, and the uterus is proliferating, and that is proliferative phase of uterine cycle. Then ovulation will occur, corpus luteum will be formed, and that is luteal phase of ovarian cycle, and uterus is secreting the uterine milk and preparing for the baby, and that is secretory phase of uterine cycle. And if pregnancy doesn't occur, corpus albicans will be formed, and then bleeding will occur, and the cycle will continue. Thank you so much for watching this video.